on It's Going in the Cloud. Okay, so good morning everyone and welcome to the English Cloud course. As you were told, my name is Maria Pia, so feel free to ask any question. And but first of all, I would like me to ask you questions because I want to know what are your interests, your needs, your necessities, your expectations from this course. As a matter of fact, I had to give a project to the school and I've written what I thought could be useful to you. I don't know whether you have been given it, a copy of it or not. But anyway, there was something like what to say at the airport, at the restaurant, in a shop, these kind of things. But we can do whatever we want to. So I want to do what's useful, what's good for you. So any suggestion is very welcome. So I would like to start with a brief, you know, introduction by all of you, something like, my name is, I am A, your job, and I applied to this course because I didn't know what to do and have some free time and or I'm preparing an exam or I need it for a certain reason so that I can understand what are your needs and your expectations and I can adapt my teaching to your needs because I'll try to do that as much as possible. So could you all understand my English up to now?
Yes, I do.
Problems? Okay, perfect. Mm-hmm. Can you start, Valé? Let's go on the gallery. Let's follow the gallery order. So in my gallery order, the first one is Valeria Mercandino. Can you start, please?
Yeah. Hi, everybody. I'm Valeria Mercandino. This is my first year of teaching. I'm a teacher in a primary school in Verona. I'm here because I want to improve and refresh my English, especially for teaching. But I don't have any special needs.
Special need, yes. Yeah. Do you teach children English in the primary school?
No. What no, just Italian.
Italian and history, geography, these kind of things. Okay. All right. Thank Giuseppe, you. Can you introduce yourself, Giuseppe Mazzeo?
Hi, I'm Giuseppe Mazzeo. I live in Verona. I'm a teacher in ICSA Verona. I teach maths and English to the children.
Ok.
Volevo dire anche, posso dire in italiano, io ho fatto, non ho la certificazione B1, però avevo fatto tutto il corso, non avevo fatto l'esame solamente l'esame. Quindi mi sono iscritto.
Yes, no problems.
Anche
no
se
problems.
In inglese, you... però lo insegno alle prime classi.
Yes, you don't need any certification to attend this course. It's okay, no problems at all.
Okay,
thank you. Ichi say, but is it a primary school?
Primary
the one
school.
You teach in primary school. Okay, so you're a primary school teacher. Perfect. Anna Notaro, can you introduce yourself, please?
Okay, hello. I'm Anna, and I'm teaching in primary school Italian, maths, history, art, music, and so on.
and a lot of things.
Yes, and
What are your expectations? What are your expectations from this course?
To improve my English.
Yeah, but especially speaking, listening, reading, writing. What?
Speaking. And speaking.
Speaking. Okay, perfect.
Thank you.
No problem. So thanks to you, Valeria. Valeria Di Giovanna.
Hello, I'm Valeria Di Giovanna. I'm a teacher in a primary school. I don't teach English, I teach math, gymnastics, arts, music. I'm here to refresh my English.
Perfect. Okay, I'm sorry, I'm replying to a couple of people. So actually you don't teach gymnastics, you teach PE, physical
PE.
Education.
Okay, okay, okay.
Physical education. Okay, okay, perfect. So you want to refresh your English because you feel
a little bit rusty.
Yeah. You feel a little bit rusty, un po' arrugginita.
Yeah.
In the meantime, sorry, I'm letting people in the video conference, but I listen to you, don't worry.
Okay.
So what are your expectations? Mainly speaking, writing, listening?
I think a little of all.
a little bit of all. Okay.
Yeah.
Hi, Carla. Carla Gobetti, can you introduce yourself?
Se te lo dico in italiano, mi hai detto che mi insegnavi che sei capace di insegnarmi l'inglese? Non credo.
Why? Okay, first of all, this is a B1 course, so it's not for beginners, but I know you're not a beginner, so don't be shy. Really, you don't have to be shy at all. The best way to learn is to practice.
Yes.
And do like your children do. Give you a chance. Try. If it's wrong, it doesn't matter. We're all here to, you know, to learn. So no problems at all. Actually, it's even better if you make mistakes, because if you make mistakes, I can correct you. And when you happen to speak to an English speaking person, you won't make the same mistake another time. So it's even better if you make mistakes. Don't you be shy.
Parlo?
Yes.
Okay, excuse, I don't hear very well. My name is Carla. I'm a teacher. I teach in San Martino in CPA school, Italian languages. I don't have a certification B1.
No problems.
I did the ministerial course for teaching in the primary school.
Okay, but
I don't speak very well English.
Don't worry.
I don't speak very well.
No, you have to go. Who's that? Anna? Is that Anna?
Yes, sorry. I am so sorry.
Okay, but, no problem. So don't you want to introduce yourself before going?
Yes, of course. My name is Anna. I am a teacher. Actually, I'm teaching in prison, and for me it's very important to speak, because a lot of my students speak English. It's very, very necessary. And now vi saluto e me ne vado.
Yes. I say goodbye to you all. And we say goodbye to you. Bye, Anna. Bye, Anna.
Ciao, grazie.
Bye. I'll send you an email with all the dates and times of the courses. Okay, so she is working for the CPIA. The CPIA, il CPA, CPIA in English. And yes, we have a lot of foreign students. Can you see the chat, can't you? Can you see the chat? Yes.
Yeah.
Foreign students. Yes, non-Italian, foreign students. Okay, Marina, can you introduce yourself, please?
Hi to everyone. I'm a teacher. I work as a teacher in a primary school. I teach Italian, history, arts, music, technology. My worst skills are listening.
My name is Elena,
speaking. Speaking. And
Okay, sorry, could you kindly switch off the microphones when you're not talking, because I can hear echo, which is not very pleasant. So please switch off the microphones when you are not talking and switch it on when you want to talk. I'm doing it for you, but yes. Okay, sorry, Marina, you are a teacher at the primary school. You teach art, history, technology, yes, a lot of things. I missed the last part.
My worst skill are listening and speaking. So,
okay.
And pronunciation, of course. And I have to revise, to improve, and to...
Yes, so I mainly need to improve the listening and speaking skills. You mainly need to improve the listening and speaking skills. Sì, ho scritto sbagliato, non so come mi è venuto fuori un lì. Ok, Gabriella, can you switch? Okay, can you switch it? Perfect.
I'm Gabriella Laudani. I'm a teacher. I'm a teacher in a primary school, Icisei, Bassona. I'm teach math and science. And for me is important speaking and listening.
Yes, ok. So you are a teacher. Ecco, ho sbagliato a scrivere perché faccio veloce, 3000 robe contemporaneamente. You are a teacher and you teach. Don't say I'm teach. I teach.
I teach.
Okay. I'm a teacher. I teach.
Okay.
Primary school pupils.
Okay.
Okay. Right. Okay. So what about Giusy? Giusy Catania.
Hi everybody, I'm Giusy Catania. I'm a teacher in a primary school. I'm from Sicily. I have lived in Verona for 4 years.
You still live in Verona, don't you? You still live in Verona, don't you? Ancora vivi a Verona, giusto?
Yes, yes, sì, sì.
See, so I've been living in Verona. I've been living because okay. It's still going on.
Okay, I still lived, been in Verona for 4 years. I teach in IC06 Bassona. I need to speak.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay, perfect. So mainly speaking. Okay. I'm trying to convince Claudia Gomez not to go. She sent me messages saying, I have to go. I don't feel like following this class, but don't worry. It's okay. I will adapt to your capabilities and abilities. So don't go, Claudia. Stay with us, whoever you are. Chiunque tu sia. But really, don't you worry. Don't you worry. Am I so frightening? Sono così spaventosa. Everybody says, oh, no, no, I have to go. No, really, don't worry. Don't worry. I will adapt to your abilities and capacities. So don't worry. Okay, so that's why you're called Catania, because you come from beautiful Sicily. How can you live here in winter time? Ecco perché ti chiami Catania, perché vieni dalla bellissima Sicilia. Come fai a resistere qua in inverno? Okay, so let's go back to everyone in the chat. Okay, Mary, can you tell us something about you? Mary? Can you switch the audio on, please?
Non so rispondere perché non ho mai fatto inglese, non so niente di inglese, mi dispiace.
Ma proprio mai fatto niente di niente?
Mai fatto niente di inglese.
Allora sì, allora questo sì, forse è un livello troppo difficile per te, perché questo è già un B1, capite?
Allora, sì, infatti stavo ascoltando.
Sì,
sto cercando di ascoltare, captare qualcosa, yes. Magari chissà riesco un
of
po'
course,
a...
Of course, stay if you want to. Stay if you want to. You are very welcome. You are very welcome. Stai se vuoi, sei la benvenuta con noi. But for absolute beginners, per i principianti assoluti, that's level A1. Then there's level A2. And then there's level B1. So this is a B1 course level. Of course, I can adapt to your needs and no problems, but if you are an absolute beginner, that's difficult, you know. But stay if you want to. You don't need to speak, simply stay and listen. It's a good, you know, it's a good activity, exercise anyway. Or no? Okay. Okay. So this is a B1 course. So I'll adapt to your abilities and capacities. But of course, ma certamente, I cannot start from the beginning. So stay with us because it's a good practice, a good exercise anyway, because it's a good practice exercise anyway, but I won't be able to make a lesson from the very beginning. I won't be able to make a lesson from the very beginning because, I mean, the other ones wouldn't be happy. Because the other ones wouldn't be happy. Perché gli altri non sarebbero contenti se partissi da 000, capito? Quindi stai, sei la benvenuta, nessun problema, anche se non parli, non importa. È sempre un buon esercizio, però non possiamo partire da zero, quello no. Mi spiace, ma... comunque nel CPA... Why am I speaking in Italian? In our CPIA, in our school, we have lessons, English classes for absolute beginners. And you can apply to one of our classes, maybe from September onwards. Abbiamo comunque nel nostro CPA anche dei corsi di inglese per principianti assoluti, a cui ti puoi iscrivere magari dal prossimo settembre, perché adesso siamo quasi a fine anno, sì. Io ho ancora 6 lezioni, non vale la pena, però da settembre, ecco. But stay with us, you're very welcome, ma stai con noi, sei comunque la benvenuta.
Grazie.
No, thank you.
Thank you.
Ok, perfect, thank you. Ok, Mariangela, tell us about yourself. Oh, what's happening? So, Mariangela.
Okay. Hi, everybody. I'm Mariangela. I'm a teacher in a primary school. I teach Italian language and arts and technology. I want to improve my English in speaking and listening.
Okay, so up to now, everybody asked for speaking and listening mainly, didn't you? Okay, so ALA297, what's your name? The next one in the gallery order.
Sorry.
Okay, so what's your name, ALA?
I'm Anna. Anna Longo.
Ok, Anna.
I'm a teacher of primary school. I live in Verona. I teach in to Palazzina.
Yes. What are your expectations from this course?
I'm maintaining the improved listening and speaking skills.
Mainly listening and speaking skills.
Yes.
You teach.
I teach math, science, art, and technology. No English.
A lot of things. Yes.
No English.
No problems. It's okay. Okay, it's interesting to see how these primary school teachers teach different subjects, but not all the same. I mean, sometimes art is combined with the technology, sometimes it's combined with the science, sometimes it's funny, interesting. Okay, so Francesca Miele, can you tell us something about yourself?
Hi, my name is Francisca.
Oh, Francisca. Are you Spanish?
No, I'm Italian, but I was born in Switzerland.
In Switzerland?
Mm-hmm. Yes. And I used to speak German and Spanish for many years. Because now I would love to improve my English.
Mm. Okay. Because vuol dire perché. So I used to speak German and Spanish, yes.
But now I would love to improve my English level.
Yes. Are you more interested in speaking, writing, listening, what?
Okay, speaking, and I want to like more fluent.
Yeah, you would like to become more fluent.
Well, yes.
Okay, you would like to become more fluent. Yes, yeah. In English. Okay, perfect. Thank you, Francisca.
You're welcome.
So who's next to Francisca? A not better defined utente. Utente, hello. Who are you? Okay, can you introduce yourself, please?
Hello, I am Renata Del Monte. I live in Colonia Veneta, Verona. I teach in primary school.
Why did you apply to this course?
Tomorrow I have, non so la parola, sostenuto, exam
tomorrow
psychology.
Tomorrow means domani. Yesterday, you had an exam in psychology.
Yes, and my mind is crazy now.
Don't worry. You had an exam in psychology. How did it go? Did you pass?
Yes.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Congratulations. Okay. Fantastic. So you're studying psychology, like my daughter. My daughter is studying psychology at the university here in Verona. But she is at the first year. She's only 20. Okay. So what about Paola?
Hello everybody, I'm Paola, I teach in the middle school.
Oh, middle school! Finally, yeah. Somebody from the middle school. I thought you were all primary school teachers.
Yes, I am a music teacher, but now from the last 10 years, I teach special education.
Yes, you're a supporting teacher. You are a supporting.
I'm a supporting teacher.
Yes.
Okay. And I'm from Perugia.
From Perugia?
Yes.
Why did you move to Verona? Why?
My school is applied to the NET Polo Europeo.
You are in Perugia now?
Yes.
Sorry. I thought you were in Verona. Okay, yes. Perfect. So you didn't move to Verona. Okay.
I'd like to improve my listening and speaking skills.
Abilities. Listening and speaking abilities, most yes. than anything else. Okay, because we have a limited number of lessons, only 12 lessons? I don't know. No, 12 hours, which means 8 lessons. So I want to do the most useful thing for you. We can't do everything in 8 lessons, so I want to do as much as possible what you need. Okay, so what about Veronica? Hi, Veronica.
Hi, I'm Veronica. I'm an infant teacher.
Kindergarten.
The first level of school.
You mean kindergarten?
Yes, in the kindergarten, yes. I use some rhymes, English rhyme, with my children because I love to sing. And I think that this is a nice way to learn English for me yes. and for the children too.
Yes, definitely. It's a nice way, it's a good way to convey the language, to yes. transmit the language. Yes. It's a very good idea. Yes.
Yes. I study too in psychology in Verona, but I'm in the second year, and I have to I have gain the I have to. Oh dear. Just a moment, I think about
no
it.
No problem, sir.
Yes, I have finished the B8 level for the university for English, but I have studied more or less 25 years ago at the Liceo Linguistico, three foreign languages. But I know that if I speak, if someone don't use the language, you can, I don't know.
You have finish. Practiced. You have yes. to keep it practiced.
Yes, thank you. And yes, I need to speak more. Because I understand very good. I have a good
level of understanding.
Yes.
You understand very well.
The context, but I think that I can improve the language. Because I have many families that come from Nigeria or Ghana. Mm-hmm. And they are very happy when I speak
English
with them in English, yes. And they say, oh, good English, but I think that is not so good.
Well, for Nigerian people, it's probably very good because they have a very strange English, very basic English themselves.
Yes, I say always, I know a tourist English, not a correct, but a tourist. Yes.
Basic English.
Okay.
Basic English. Yes. Yes, you studied English yes. in a linguistic school 25 years ago. It's a finished time. So you use I have studied sim. Only when the past has a connection with the present.
Yes.
So for example, I am very good because I have studied for 25 years. But if you say, I studied English 25 years ago, that's finished as a time. So you cannot say, I have studied, ho sbagliato a scrivere I, but I studied. Ok, quindi questo passato, have più participio passato, si usa solo quando il passato ha ancora dei collegamenti col presente. Per esempio, parlo bene inglese perché l'ho studiato per 25 anni. Allora, I have studied English for 25 years. Ma se uno dice, ho studiato inglese 25 anni, punto, I studied English, è passato, non ha nessun collegamento col presente e quindi si usa il passato, punto e fine. Ok? Questa è la differenza. Va bene, se volete vi preparerò un video tra il simple past, la differenza tra simple past e quell'altro tipo di passato. Present perfect. Present perfect. Sì, questo che hai usato tu, I have studied, is called the present perfect because it has a connection with the present.
Yes, I know, yes, it's a common mistake that I do. I know the rules, but it's so different for our verbs form in Italy. Because we say, ho studiato, so I use the translate, okay. But I know that it's not right.
Correct, but yes. Correct,
yes.
As a matter of fact, we use the past tenses in a completely different way in Italian. So don't you think about Italian language. Yeah. Concentrate on thinking in English. In English, when something has happened, when something is finished, whether it's finished, I don't know, 2 minutes ago or 20 years ago or 20 centuries ago, it doesn't make any difference. It's past. On the contrary, when something has happened in the past, but it's still connected with the present, in this case, you use the verb to have plus the past participle. But don't worry if it's if this is a something difficult for you, I will make a video for you with the entire explanations and examples and so on, and I will send it to you by WhatsApp or maybe email. Okay, so thank you for the suggestion.
Sorry, and the future too. Because there are different ways to different forms
of the future. Okay, right.
Thank you.
Okay.
Maria Pia.
Yes.
Excuse me. May you explain to us also the present perfect continuous?
Yes, I have been living. Yes. For example, who told us I have been living in Verona for 4 or 5 years? That means that she came to Verona, she has started living in Verona, and she's still going on living in Verona. So, I have been living. Okay. It's a little bit complicated, to be honest, but it comes from I am living. It's the present. I am living. But if you also want to say that it started in the past, that verb to be becomes I have been living. Okay, let's do this. There are two types of present tenses. I study, for example, and I'm studying. One is an everyday action, a usual action, which happens every time I study. And the other one is an action which is happening now. I am studying now, okay? In the past, I study becomes I studied and because Y becomes I, but it doesn't matter. And I'm studying becomes I've been studying. Because that verb to be is conjugated with have plus the past participle. I have been studying. You know what I can do for you? I can prepare a, how can I say, frame, a chart with all the different tenses of the verbs so that by comparing them, you can understand everything much better. So chart, verb chart. Verb chart. Okay, I'll prepare a verb chart for you. And I'll send it to you. Okay,
thank you.
So many things, support me. Okay, so who's next? Alessandra Papa something. I thought I heard you before.
Yes, I wrong yesterday.
Oh, you came into the wrong course yesterday.
Yes.
B2.
No, in fact, B1 today is
it's better
for today.
Don't you want to do both? Don't you want to do both? Don't you want to do both? I don't mind if you want to. I don't mind if you want to. I don't mind means it's okay for me. No problems on my part.
Okay.
So I don't mind if you want to stay in both classes, since you were accepted, which is not my competence, but since you were accepted, stay in both classes. Take advantage. Take okay. advantage.
Thank of you.
Both classes. But can you introduce yourself for the other?
Yes, I am a teacher in a primary school. I live in Vicenza. I teach Italian, history, PE, and I'm here for myself, for speaking English well.
Yes, better.
Better.
Oh my God, I've got 25 messages from your WhatsApp group. Io non sento, io non vedo, ora è così, scusate, non riesco a entrare. Assunta è entrata poi alla fine, ah, eccoti là, perfetto. Costanza è entrata poi alla fine?
Yes, yes.
Ok, perfect.
Il telefono. Assunta, bla bla bla. Dal computer, vabbè.
Ok.
Ok, hi, I'm Assunta Cricodio. And I'm a teacher in a primary school, Viglio, in Verona. This year I teach arts, physics, and supporting teacher.
Physics, you mean PE, physical education? What do you mean for physics?
Educazione fisica.
Sì, allora PE, physical education. PE che sta per physical education. Physical education, PE, loro la chiamano. Perché se dici physics sembra la fisica, la science. PE, physical education, PE. Okay, perfect. And what do you want to do in these classes? Do you want to speak? Do you want to listen? Do you want to write? Do you want to read? What would you like to do?
A supporting teacher, no.
Yes, but in...
In language, in classes, math,
what would you like to
the
do?
The first class, and in the second, third.
No. In these English classes, sorry. In English lessons, what would you like to do? With us, with me. What would you like to do?
Speak very well.
Try and speak as much as possible.
Because okay. I understand, but not very well speak.
Improve your speaking abilities.
Yes.
Okay. Improve your speaking abilities. Sì, sì. Che cavolo sto scrivendo? Improve your speaking abilities. Okay. Yeah. Right. But after Alessandra Pappalardo, there's a Galaxy J3. Who's the Galaxy J3? Hello. Can you introduce yourself? In between Alessandra Pappalardo and Monica in my gallery, I've got a certain Galaxy J3.
Serena.
Serena.
Okay, Serena, can you write your name?
Okay, okay.
Okay, Serena, if you go with your mouse on the upper right corner of your picture, there are three dots. There are three dots. If you click on them, you can rename and you can write your name.
My name is Serena.
Yes.
Serena. But
don't you want to write it? Wait. Rename. Okay. Serena.
Serena Zampini.
Okay, I did it for you. Serena. Okay.
Serena Zampini. I'm teacher in primary school in Chievo. It is say, I religion teacher.
Oh, you teach religion. Religion. Okay. So how many hours do you teach per week? How many hours per week?
In a week, 22.
Non ho scritto niente. Perché non ho scritto niente? Allora. How many hours per week? No, I mean each class. Okay, 2 hours per class. So you have 11 classes.
11 classes.
Oh my God. Poor you. Poor you. Poor you. Okay, so, right. So what do you expect from this course, English course?
For listening and speaking when better.
Okay, listening and speaking. Everybody wants listening and speaking mainly. Okay, perfect. Nobody cares about grammar. Okay. Okay, Monica, can you introduce yourself, please?
I am Monica Tardiani. I am a teacher in the middle school.
Oh, middle school teacher.
I teach Italian and German. And
history,
I would like, yes. I would like speak a little better.
I would like to speak.
Yeah.
Yes, actually, after like, when like is in the present form, we use the inform for the word, for the verb afterwards. For example, I like reading, I like speaking, I like studying, I like whatever, watching TV. But when there's the form I would like, I would like to speak, I would like to read, I would like to watch. So, okay, in the present, I like plus ing form. But when you say I would like, it goes back to the infinitive form, to speak, to watch, to, okay. So you would like to speak more than anything else. Perfect. What about Cecilia?
Hi everybody, I'm Cecilia De Marco. I teach in primary school in IC6 in Verona. I don't teach English in my school. I teach math, science, PE and music. My English is basic and I improve speaking, writing and listening.
Okay, I'd like to improve speaking, writing, and listening.
Okay.
The first who wants to improve writing. Okay. What about Nadia?
Hello, everyone. Hello, Mary. I met her in the Baldolino School. Do you remember me? Mary?
You met me?
No, Mary. Oh. I met Mary.
Okay. Who's Mary?
The girls that don't speak English, doesn't speak English. So
maybe that's why she couldn't. Ah, Mary, yeah. Mary, yeah. Dice che vi conoscete. Nadia dice che vi conoscete dalla scuola di Bardolino. She's waving hello to you.
Ciao, scusa. I'm a teacher of a primary school. I don't know the name, the right name of the maestra prevalente, main teacher. I don't know the name.
Maestra?
Prevalente, main teacher. I teach.
Prevalente, yes, main teacher. Yeah. The main teacher.
Yeah, so I teach Italian,
the head math. Teacher. Head teacher. Anche. Okay. Head teacher.
So I teach Italian, math, science, history, and geography. But I have to improve my English because next summer I'll move my fam to Malta.
To?
Malta.
Malta! Yeah. Fantastic! I hope you'll be able to go. I hope you will be able to go.
Yeah, I hope. So I have to... to speak better.
Yeah, okay. Yes, they speak English in Malta, of course. Yeah. I hope you'll be able to go. Spero che potrai andarci, perché with this coronavirus, oh my God, yeah. I'm not sure. But yes, let's cross fingers.
Yeah.
Let's cross fingers, or let's touch wood. Let's touch wood. Ah sì, è vero, noi diciamo tocchiamo ferro, loro dicono tocchiamo legno. Let's touch wood, tocchiamo legno, o let's cross fingers. In questo caso è meglio let's cross fingers.
Cross fingers. Okay.
Let's touch wood is something like you might die. Oh no, let's touch wood. Potresti morire, no, tocchiamo legno.
No. Okay.
Esatto. In questo caso era più let's cross fingers.
Perfetto.
Incrociamo le dita. Malta, ok. Must be beautiful, never been there, but must be very nice.
Oh, yeah.
So, Valeria Di Giovanna. Valeria, tell us about yourself.
I have talking about me.
Oh, you've already done it, okay.
Yeah.
Because you moved in the gallery. Okay, okay, sorry. What about Assunta? Can you hear us, Assunta?
Già fatto. Poco fa mi sono
già fatto. Sì. Why don't you start your video? What about Carla Gobetti? Carla Gobetti anche già fatto. Who's missing? Has everybody talked? Tutti avete parlato? Okay. So I would summing up, dove è andato a scrivere adesso? Ok, summing up, most of you need to talk, to speak. Most of you need or want to speak as much as possible. Right. So, let's start speaking. Allora cominciamo a parlare. Perfect. In my program, I think the first lesson was supposed to be the airport, what to say, how to... Okay, but before... Okay, maybe before starting learning all the airport vocabulary and so on, let's start with the more basic things, like normal questions. For example, Valeria, when was the last time you went to an airport?
My last time in the airport was last year.
Last year. Okay, stop there. Let's ask her questions. For example, dove sei andata? Dove sei andata? So? Nobody volunteers?
Okay.
Wait for the question.
Okay.
Anybody volunteers for the question, Serena?
Nessuno? Where did you stay?
Dove sei andata? Nel senso, ha preso meglio, ma dove è andata? Where did you go?
I went to USA.
To the US or USA, va bene tutto, US però è scritto maiuscolo, US oppure USA. Oh, you went to the USA, fantastic! Yeah. Allora, con chi ci sei andata? Io sono curiosa, I'm very curious.
Wait for
the question. Allora, chi chiede, con chi ci sei andata?
Who come with you?
Who went with you? Chi è andato con te? Va bene.
Ok.
Però se tu volessi chiedere tu con chi ci sei andata, who did you go with? Who did you go with? Please don't forget. Okay. There's a lot of things to say here. Okay, first of all, the WH words always come first. WH words are always first. They want to be the first in the sentence. So if you need to put something before them, it's brought to the end of the sentence. For example, where are you from? Not from where are you, but where are you from? Okay, who did you go with? Okay, not with who. Who did you go with? Where are you from? What is it for? What is it for? What is it for? A cosa serve? What is it for? Ok, quindi queste WH words, parole che iniziano con la WH, who, why, where, what, how, ok, how è un po' strano, ma comunque è sempre rientra tra i WH, how, vogliono sempre essere messi per primi nella frase. Quindi il nostro con chi ci sei andato diventa who, chi, did you go with? Chi ci sei andato con? Ok? First. Then, look at this. Later Monica will get in. Ok? No problems. Will get in. Better. E will è scritto will.
Okay. Maria Pia, sorry. Excuse me, I have another appointment, a job appointment right now. I have to go. I have to leave.
We wanted to know about your US holiday.
Next time.
Okay. Yeah. Bye, Valeria.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Oh, no. That was a good, you know, discussion. Anyway, look at these two sentences. Who did you go with? E who, dove era l'altra? Who went with you? Who went with
Excuse
you?
Excuse me, Maria Pia.
Yes.
I have to go
as well.
For video lesson.
What time is it?
At 6 p.m.
Okay.
Sorry.
See you next week.
Bye bye.
No problems.
Bye bye.
There is the recording of the lesson anyway. C'è la registrazione, which will be sent to you.
Very well.
Spedita, so.
Thank you. Thank you.
Problems. Bye.
Thank Bye-bye. You. Bye. Bye bye.
Bye.
Cosa stavo dicendo? Ah, sì, look at these two sentences. Who went with you? Who did you go with? Cosa succede? Che nella seconda c'è il did che fa la domanda e nella prima no. Come mai? Perché il Q, come tutti WH parole, vuole essere per primo. Per fare la domanda bisognerebbe metterci qualcosa davanti, tipo did o can o are o qualunque roba. Ma lui non vuole proprio. Allora fa a meno di prendere la parola che indica la domanda. Who went? Quando il who è soggetto, non serve fare la domanda con il do, did, con l'inversione, eccetera, eccetera. Ok? Quindi, who went with you? Invece, nella seconda frase, il soggetto è you. Quindi, oddio, cosa è successo qua? Who did you go with? Ok? Who did you go with? Per fare questa domanda ci vuole il did davanti. Who did you go? E il who se ne sta per conto suo per primo, o tranquillo, beato, contento e non si lamenta. Ok? Quindi vi ricordo che le parole con la WH tipo who, why, what, where, how, vogliono sempre stare davanti. Sono un po' antipatiche, vero? Quando qualcuno si mette davanti a loro, gli danno un calcione e lo sbattono in fondo alla frase. Who do you go with? Who did you go with? Ok? Va bene. I'm speaking Italian. Why am I speaking Italian? Perché sto parlando in italiano? Sorry. Ok, so who did you go? Ok, but Valeria has gone. So, let's start with Giuseppe. Giuseppe, when was the last time you went to an airport?
I don't go to an airport last year.
You went to the airport last year?
Don't go.
You never go to the airport. So, no. Why did you say last year?
I'm staying in Verona.
Yes. I never go to the airport. I stay in Verona. I think this is a strategy to avoid questions. Io credo che questa sia una strategia. Okay, what about Anna? When was the last time you went to an airport?
I went to the airport 2 years ago, to Naples. 2 years ago.
Ok, 2 years ago. Allora, chi gli chiede perché? Dove sei andata?
Naples.
We need to ask you questions. Dobbiamo farti le domande. Ok, so, dove sei andata? Chi glielo chiede?
Where did you go?
Where did you go? Ok? Per fare la domanda ci vuole il did e di conseguenza go torna alla forma base. Where did you go? Invece nella risposta il did non c'è più e quindi
I went to Naples.
Where did you go? I went to Naples. Perfect. Con chi ci sei andata? Nobody volunteers?
Who did you go with?
Oppure who went with you?
Ma però who went with you non vuol dire con chi ci sei andata, vuol dire chi è andato con te. Okay. Però va bene.
Who did you go with? I went alone.
You went alone. Perché sei andata a Napoli?
Why did you go to Naples?
Because is my city.
Ah, because I'm from Naples.
Yes.
Because you are from Naples. Oh, fantastic.
But I live in Verona.
But now you live in Verona. Again, how can you stand our winters? How can you stand our winters? Come fai a sopportare I nostri inverni? Io veramente penso a tutte queste persone che vengono...
It's very hard.
It's very hard. It's hard. It's hard. Okay, but Verona is a beautiful city.
Yes.
But Naples too. Okay, so are you in Verona now or are you back in Naples? Are you in Verona now?
Now I'm staying.
Yes, you live in Verona now, but in this moment, are you in
this
Verona?
Moment, yes.
Ma you couldn't go back to Naples, non hai potuto tornare a Napoli.
No.
Tutto chiuso.
No.
Okay.
In the summer, perhaps.
Yes, are you, scusate, ho saltato you. Are you in Verona? Perché scrivendo velocemente, vabbè. Are you in Verona now? Yes, I am.
Yes.
Okay, c'era qualcuno che voleva fare una domanda? No?
How long did you stay in Naples?
Perfect. How long did you stay in Naples? How long did you... C'è un punto di domanda ovviamente finale. How long did you stay in Naples? How long? Quanto tempo?
I stayed in Naples... adesso non ricordo se for o il
no, non serve niente. Beh, anche for o anche niente. I stayed in Naples 2 months. I stayed 2 months, 2 weeks, 2 days, quello che vuoi.
Hey.
I stayed
for summer.
I spent allora the summer sarebbe meglio. I spent the summer there. I spent the summer there. Perché hai passato, ci hai passato l'estate,
sì.
Non sei stata, ci
only
hai passato.
Summer, yes.
The summer. I spent the summer there. Ok. Come sei andata, come ci sei andata a Napoli? Chi glielo chiede?
How did you go there?
How did you go there?
Excuse me, can I ask a question?
Sure.
But to say how long you spend in a place, can you use I have been in Naples for 2 weeks for the summer?
No, because if you say I have been in Naples, means that you are still there.
Ah, okay. I had been.
But you are not in Naples anymore. So it's a finished time.
Ah, okay.
So I stayed in Naples.
Okay. Okay.
I have been staying means that you are still there. Okay. Va bene. So how did you go there? What did you say? How did you go there? By plane?
I went with my car.
By car,
sì, sorry.
Allora, attenzione, per i mezzi di trasporto, sempre by car, by train, by boat, by plane, by bicycle, the only exception is on foot. On foot. In tutti gli altri casi, by car, by bicycle, by train, by plane, by boat, by whatever. By motorbike, quello che volete. Tutto by. Ok, so you went by car. Quanto ci hai messo? Wait for the question.
Yes.
How long do you reach to go there? No.
How long did it take? Take si usa per il tempo. Quindi, it took me 7 hours. Okay, allora, it took me 7 hours. Since she went by car, it's better to say it took me 7 hours. If she had gone by plane, for example, it took 2 hours, 1 hour and a half. Allora, se lei fosse andata in aereo, sarebbe 1 ora e mezza, perché è così, l'aereo ci mette 1 ora e mezza, o anche col treno. 5 ore. Mm-hmm. Ma siccome è andata in macchina,
by car,
allora it took me 7 hours. Io ci ho messo 7 ore, ci ho messo io 7 ore, ma magari uno va più veloce, ce ne mette 6, magari uno si ferma ogni 10 metri, ce ne mette 8, ok? Quindi quando è una cosa relativa, cioè personale, it took me 7 hours. Se invece è una cosa tipo treno, aereo, che è al di fuori del vostro controllo, it took 2 hours, it took 5 hours.
Ah, okay.
Perché è così, cioè l'aereo ci mette così, il treno ci mette così, ok? Ma invece con la macchina, it took me 7 hours. Ok, it took me 7 hours. Ma hai fatto il viaggio da sola? Who volunteers?
Did you go alone?
No. Okay, or did you travel alone?
Travel alone. Did you try on your own?
Did you go alone? Did you travel alone?
On your own.
On your own?
On your own.
Yes, I do.
Yes, I did.
I did.
Yes, I did. Yes, I did. Ti piace guidare?
Do you like driving? Yes, I like.
Ricordo che dopo il like ci va la forma in inglese. Do you like driving?
Yes, I like.
I do. Quando si fanno le risposte si ripete l'ausiliare. Mm-hmm. Quindi, can you drive? Yes, I can. Are you good at driving? Yes, I am.
I do.
Do you like driving? Yes, I do.
I do.
Did you drive? Yes, I did. Ok, si ripete sempre il verbo con il quale si fa la domanda.
Posso anche rispondere yes, I'd like. No.
No, I'd like dire mi piacerebbe, vorrei.
I'd like driving.
I'd like vuol dire vorrei, mi piacerebbe. I'd like è l'abbreviazione di...
No, sorry. I like to drive.
I like driving.
Okay.
I like driving. Sì, poi per carità ti capiscono lo stesso, Però grammaticalmente è più corretto.
Non è corretto.
I like driving. Ok, so 7 hours by car. Sei stata con la tua famiglia o dove sei stata? Chi glielo chiede?
Where did you go? What did you visit?
Allora, sei stata nel senso in albergo, breakfast con la tua famiglia, in campeggio. Ok, so where did you stay?
I stayed with my at my home with my family.
With my family. Ecco. I stayed with my family. Good. Hai visitato qualche cosa?
Did you visit something?
Ok, did you visit something? Or somewhere or something? So did you visit something?
I went to visit Cristo Velato. I went to the beach.
Yes, I went to the seaside oppure to the beach.
And I went with my friend.
And I went out with my friends.
It non mi ricordo il passato. It
ate, mangiare,
ate. Pizza.
My friends for a pizza. And I went out with my friends for a pizza. E sono uscita con i miei amici per a mangiare la pizza. Sì, loro non sanno dire a mangiare la pizza. For a pizza.
Ah, ok.
Sì.
Pizza.
Dopo il verbo andare non si dice a fare, di solito viene shortened, abbreviato. Quindi vado a fare una passeggiata, I go for a walk. Vado a mangiare la pizza, I go for a pizza. I go out for lunch, ok? Loro abbreviano, non dicono vado a fare qualcosa, vado per questo. So you went out with your friends for a pizza. You went out for a pizza. Mm. Pizza in Naples. Delicious. Delicious. I haven't been eating a pizza for more than a month by now. I, vedete, haven't been eating a pizza for more than a month by now. Non mangio una pizza da più di un mese. Vedete, I haven't been eating a pizza for more than a month by now. Perché continua ancora, purtroppo. Anche oggi non andrò a mangiare la pizza, maledizione. Ok? Va bene. Allora, però c'è gente che parla poco, dovete parlare tutti. You must all participate in the conversation. I want to hear all of you. All of you. Don't worry if you make mistakes. It's okay if you make mistakes. I enjoy correcting your mistakes.
That's my job.
It's my job. No, it's not that I enjoy, but it's okay if you make mistakes. So don't you worry, really. So please participate, all of you, all of you. Because you know what? If you listen to something, maybe you understand. But if you practice, that's when you learn. By using the language, you learn it. If you simply listen, yes, you understand, maybe you remember a little bit, but when it's time to speak, there's a gap, you know, from being able to speak and understanding. Ok, se ascoltate solo, magari capite, per carità, imparate, ma è solo praticando la lingua che veramente si impara. Parlando, magari voi dite, ah sì, ho capito, ma poi quando è il momento di parlare, c'è un abisso tra il fatto di aver capito e il fatto di saperlo usare. Infatti. Quindi, really, the only way to learn is to practice. L'unica maniera per imparare è praticare, provare, fare pratica. Quindi, don't worry for your mistakes, no problems at all. Please speak, speak, speak. You came here to speak. Avete detto tutti che siete venuti per imparare a parlare. E non parlate.
Pia, Pia, posso chiederti una cosa?
Sì, certo.
Allora, la mia difficoltà, grande difficoltà, è che quando qualcuno parla in velocità, faccio fatica a capire.
Practice. Practice makes perfect. Practice.
Tutto practice.
A practice.
Practice makes perfect. È un proverbio inglese. Come si può dire in italiano? Practice makes perfect.
C'è qualcosa oltre la pratica, magari? Non lo so.
Oh. You simply have to listen, no. listen.
Orecchio?
Yes.
La pratica rende perfetti? Cos'è?
Sì, però c'è un proverbio simile in italiano. Che adesso non mi viene in mente come si dice in italiano.
Sbagliando si impara.
Brava, sì, forse anche sbagliando si impara, però ce n'è anche un altro. Practice makes perfect.
La pratica vale più della grammatica.
Ecco, c'era quello. Forse, esatto. Comunque, practice makes perfect. It's only a matter of practicing it. It's only It's only a matter of practicing. È solo una questione di far pratica.
Provare per credere.
Provare per credere?
Potrebbe.
No, practice makes perfect.
È solo questione di pratica.
Sì, è solo questione di pratica. Allora, vediamo chi è che non ha ancora parlato. Boh, Francesca Miele mi pare silenziosa, anche Gabriella non ha detto granché, no. Per non parlare di Cecilia o di Carla o di... Allora, chi...
When you speak, I understand all. You speak very well, very clear.
Okay, thank you very much indeed. And you did very well too. You did very well too. Anche tu hai parlato molto bene. I totally agree with you. And more than anything else, I totally agree. No, aspetta. Agree with you. E più di tutto, I totally agree with you. Sono completamente d'accordo con te. Sono molto brava a parlare. I totally agree with you. Okay, so you did very well. Anche tu fai molto bene, vai molto bene, hai fatto molto bene. You did very well. You did it invece vuol dire ce l'hai fatta. You did it. You did it. Congratulations.
You did it. Thank you.
Or you made it. Ma you did it anche. Okay, so let's see. Francesca Miele. When was the last time you went to an airport?
It was this January.
In January. One of the last journeys.
Yeah.
Uno degli ultimi viaggi che si poteva fare. Okay, last January. Last January, chi fa delle domande? Dove è andata? Con chi è andata?
Where did you go?
I went to Naples.
No. To Naples.
Sei di Napoli? Chi è che glielo chiede? Sei di Napoli?
Are you from Naples?
Yes, I'm from Naples.
Weren't you from Switzerland?
My life is complicated.
Complicated, okay. I thought you told us you were from Switzerland. Mi pare che avessi detto
I was born in Switzerland, but my grandparents are Italian. And I was born in Switzerland. I grew up in Naples.
Grew up, è il passato. Grew up in Naples.
Yes. And
now you live in Verona.
Yes, but in the last 20 years I was living in Switzerland.
I lived in Switzerland, perché è passato. I lived in Switzerland. Okay, all right. So, Naples. Okay, chi li chiede come c'è andata, con chi c'è andata, quanto c'è stata, eccetera, eccetera?
Who did you go with?
Who did you go with? Ta-da.
I went with my husband.
Husband?
No, ferma,
ti facciamo noi le domande. Allora, c'ho un marito, avrà anche dei figli?
Have you got any children?
Yes, I've got twins.
Three children? Oh my God, ma quanti anni avrà? Chi glielo
chiede? How old are they?
How old are you?
Oh no, okay.
How old are you?
First of all, how old are you? Three children. How old
nine,
are you?
Nine,
two. Twins.
Hi, that's your husband. Hello.
How are you?
Nice to meet you.
To meet you too.
Quindi, I've got the twins, hai detto.
Yeah, how old are they?
I've got twins, non serve dire children. Twins just intend the children. I've got twins. Ok, so how old are they? Giustamente qualcuno ha chiesto. How old are they?
They are 4 years.
Oh my God!
Four!
Four, yes.
How cute, Jessica. How cute.
Now my life is terrible.
Excuse me, Francisca.
I'm very busy, very busy.
Francisca,
my life is very busy. Yes, I suppose twins are very demanding.
Francisca.
I suppose twins are very demanding. Immagino che demanding? I gemelli siano un bel impegno. Perché two,
yes, of course.
Go together at the same time. Oh my God.
Francisca. Okay. Excuse me, Francisca. Are they male or female? Boy or girls? Boys or girls?
Males or females?
Boys.
Boys. As a matter of fact.
Oh my God, poor.
Two boys. Oh, poor Francisca.
Poor Francisca.
Poor husband. Two boys. Okay, as a matter of fact, males and females, it's okay, they understand you, but it's usually used for animals. For babies, we say she babies. She babies. Or he babies, or when they are not babies anymore, when they are children, boys or girls. Okay. So, perché males and females, either it's an anagraphic form, o è una, è un tipo un, come si chiama in italiano, un certificato anagrafico, che allora c'è scritto male, female, così queste cose qua ufficiali. Se no, parlando, male, female è usato per gli animali. Per le persone, se sono piccoli, neonati, si usa he baby, she baby, e se no comincia a essere boy, girl, eccetera, eccetera. Young lady... lad e così via. Va bene. Two boys. Oh my God. Allora, ma io non ho capito bene com'è andata a Napoli. Wait for the question.
How did you go?
How did you go?
Go there
by plane. Go there by plane. E quanto ci avete messo?
How long?
Wait a second, wait for the question.
How long did it take?
How long did it take? Bravissima Carla, how long did it take?
One half hour.
About?
1 hour and a half.
1 hour and a half. About 1 hour and a half. 1 hour and a half. La L non si sente, come se non ci fosse. Tantissime volte in inglese ci sono many times it happens in English there are letters which are written but not pronounced. In this case the L of half is not pronounced. So imagine it doesn't exist. Half is the correct pronunciation. And our, the H doesn't exist in the pronunciation. Our. So 1 hour and a half. H is usually pronounced in English, but there are very few exceptions, and our is one of them. You do not pronounce the H in our. La H di solito si pronuncia in inglese, però ci sono pochissime eccezioni e our è una di queste. La H in our non si pronuncia. So 1 hour and a half, 1 hour and a half. Però se avesse dovuto scriverlo sarebbe stato così. 1 hour and a half. Oppure 1 and a half hour, va bene. Ma meglio 1 hour and a half.
Did your babies come with you?
In Naples?
No, we went alone.
Only you and your husband?
Ah. Yes, just for 2 days.
Did your baby...
I tuoi bambini.
Did you visit something?
Chi glielo chiede?
What?
Which question
to stay with
your children? Who did you have?
Who did your children stay with? Who did your children stay with?
Who did you stay with?
They stayed with the grandmother and grandfather.
Sarebbero grandparents. They stayed with their grandparents.
Yes.
They stayed with their grandparents. Oh, but if you've got grandparents, that's a great help. That's a great help. Ah beh, allora se hai nonni, dai, è un grande aiuto. That's a great help. È un grande aiuto. That's a great help. Ok. Ma tutti che sono andati a Napoli? Era così bello quella che era andata negli Stati Uniti. Valeria, perché ci hai lasciato?
Valeria, I went to Madrid.
You went to Madrid, good. Yes. Let's ask about Madrid.
2 months ago.
Two?
2 months ago.
2 months ago!
In February.
Oh my God, are you positive to coronavirus?
Yes. But in Madrid, at that time, the people was more relaxing than us.
And you can see the results. You can
they
see the
aren't
results. E si vedono i risultati.
Yes.
See the results. Poor people.
They aren't scared.
They weren't scared. They weren't scared. They weren't frightened. They weren't scared. Yes, were you lucky enough not to catch coronavirus? Sei stata abbastanza fortunata da non prendere.
Yes.
Questo infinito negativo si fa mettendo not più l'infinito. Were you lucky enough not to catch? Quindi quando si deve fare un infinito negativo si mette il not davanti. Ah sì, to be or not to be. What happened? Somebody is sharing. Carla, you are sharing your screen.
Stiamo condividendo lo schermo di qualcuno.
Stop sharing your screen. Carla
Gobetti.
Carla Gobetti.
Sto guardando, infatti.
Ah, ok. Okay. On top of your screen, there should be a small green, button? Stop sharing.
Yes.
Click on stop sharing. Up on the top of the screen.
È bloccato.
Ah, ok.
Devi aspettare, you have to wait.
Maria Pia,
yes.
volevo fotografare tutte le frasi che hai messo nella chat.
Ve le mando.
E ho bloccato tutto, non so perché, adesso non riesco più a entrare.
Ah. Ok, can you go out and log in again?
Meeting?
Yes, end meeting and log in again.
I press back to meeting, but I don't go.
No, you have to press the green
meeting.
Button stop share. Devi premere il bottoncino verde dove c'è scritto stop sharing, che è su in alto. È in alto dello schermo. Io da qua non lo vedo, però in alto dello schermo dovrebbe esserci un bottoncino verde. Stop sharing.
Ecco,
fatto. Okay, well done. Brava. Perché non sto più scrivendo? Well done. Okay. Well done.
Do you send the?
I will send you all the sentences. Okay. Don't worry. I will send you the recording and the entire chat.
Okay.
And can I send you some homeworks?
Yes, of course.
Yes.
Do you hate me for that?
No, no. Not at all.
Will I be able to sleep at night? Allora, won't you hate me for that, will I be able to sleep at night? So I want, non è venuta fuori la doppia iniziale. Want si scrive, want è l'abbreviazione di will not becomes won't. So won't you hate me for that? Non mi odierete per questo?
No. No.
Potrò dormire tranquilla la notte? Okay, so what time is it? Oh my god, it's already 5 past. I mean 25 to 7, 5 past the finish time. Okay, so I will send you some homeworks and the verb chart, something about the simple past and the present perfect. And the future. Oh my God, so many things. Right. And maybe something about these WH questions. Some exercises about the WH questions. Okay, so any suggestion for next time? If you think about something, feel free to propose it on the WhatsApp group. Don't worry, feel free to propose anything you want to do on the WhatsApp group and I will adapt and will do what you want to do. Okay, se pensate, se vi viene in mente qualcosa che volete fare, sentitevi liberissimi di scriverlo nel gruppo WhatsApp e io faccio quello che voi volete fare. Because I want to do what you want to do.
Thank you.
Okay, so it was really very nice to be
with you
today.
Thank you very much.
I'll stay there. I'll take a picture in case I need to write the presents. Stay there.
Smile.
With the names and everything. In case I need to write who was at the lesson and who wasn't.
Mm-hmm.
So it was really very nice to be with you today and I'm looking forward to meeting you again on Tuesday, next Tuesday,
yes.
5 o'clock, from 5 to 6:30.
Yes.
Okay.
So bye-bye everyone. Have a nice weekend.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Nice weekend.
Have a nice
goodbye.
Bye.
Bye.